Welcome back to our Cold Working 101 video series. Today we're going to be talking about pumice. Now, pumice is basically just a volcanic rock that's crushed up. It is a great abrasive for pre-polishing your glass, though. The nice thing about pumice is that it is pH neutral, is chemically neutral, and it's just slightly harder than the glass. So it's going to give you a really nice finish on your glass when you work with it. So pumice is about a 6 on the Mohs scale, whereas glass is about 5, 5.5. So it's really close to the glass, but it is slightly harder. Now the nice thing about pumice is it's incredibly friable. Now if you've watched any of our other videos on abrasives, you'll know that friability is how quickly an abrasive will break down. Pumice is extremely friable. So as it breaks, it maintains its sharpness, but gets finer and finer and finer. So it will clean your glass and give you a really nice pre-polish finish to work from. Now, when you talk about pumice, it can be graded in microns or grits, but that's a little misleading. If you look at something like this pumice, which is a 2F pumice, and this is a 4F pumice, these are both extremely fine pumice. They're both graded about the same area of what a 325 grit would be. But that's not really what's going to happen to your glass with this. Remember, there are a couple of different things going on. If you've watched our other videos on abrasives, you'll remember that you have both the hardness of the abrasive, the friability of the abrasive, the sharpness of the abrasive. All those things go into how that abrasive is going to react with your glass. A 325 grit diamond is going to be much more aggressive on your glass than a 325 grit silicon carbide, which will be much more aggressive on your glass than something that's about like a 325 grit in a pumice. Always going by the grit sizes or the micron sizes of your abrasive is not really telling you the whole story about what it's gonna do to your glass. That's why I tend not to really focus too much on the micron size or the grit level of what pumices are. I like to grade pumices in degrees of fine. I talked about our 2F pumice and our 4F pumice here. That's how those are graded. So this is a double fine pumice, and this is a quadruple fine pumice. This pumice right here is our 0.5, which is 0 1/2. So 0 and above gets a little bit more abrasive. 0 and below gets a little finer. So below 0, you'll have 1F, 2F, 3F, 4F pumices, and on down the line. Above 0, you'll have the 1/2, which is a little more abrasive, and you can see from this that it's a little sandier. This is a number 1 pumice, and it's almost like play sand in a way. It's very abrasive feeling on your fingers, and it really just kind of moves like sand. If you move over to these finer pumices, you can tell it's a much finer abrasive because it's powdery and wants to clump together. It's a really fine abrasive. Now, pumice is a great way to pre-polish your glass or even just leave a really fine surface on your glass. They are an excellent choice to move to after you sandblast your pieces and you want a little bit more of a lustrous texture to your glass. It's a great way to do it is to use pumice. Pumice has typically been used after slurry grinding with loose grit silicon carbide. It was a pretty common way to move from silicon carbide to a pre-polish on your glass before moving to cerium oxide for a polish. It's becoming less and less of a process now, but the old ways still work pretty well. Most of the time you would see it done on an upright polisher, where you would have a horsehair wheel on one side with pumice and a felt wheel on the other side with cerium oxide. You can also find polishing wheels that will have cork wheels on one side. Cork is also used with pumice to achieve a pre-polish finish, and it works great. You'll see these cork wheels on polishing stations all the time. Another option for polishing stations on a lathe is Pulper's MJ material. Now, this is their same extruded urethane material that they apply both cerium oxide into and aluminum oxide as abrasive wheels. This wheel instead has these tiny little fibers in the wheel. So used on a polishing station or a lathe, these little fibers will help the pumice move into areas and pre-polish your glass and give you a really nice finish on your glass very, very quickly. So it's like a modern version of a cork wheel with a little added benefit of all these little fibers to help the pumice work a little bit faster for you. If you cast glass or have a lot of pieces that have sort of a bas relief surface on them where you have areas that you really need to get into, if you're doing battuto work where you've ground lenses into your pieces and you don't particularly want to polish them, then you can move to something like a brush wheel. These are cactus fibers that are mounted onto a brush that go onto a lathe. This can be used with pumice to get into areas that are harder to reach with flat wheels like the MJ or cork wheels. These work fantastic for cast work that have different surface levels on them for getting in and around pieces to give you a really beautiful finish on your glass without having to move all the way to a polish with those areas. So brush wheels and pumice are an excellent way to achieve what you might consider a dirty polish. It'll be semi-translucent, it'll look really nice and lustrous, and you don't always have to move to a cerium polish on the pieces that are really hard to get into. So brush wheels and pumice are a great step in that direction. For flat lap use with pumice, you don't see it as much, but it is possible and it works really quite well. You can use a number of different things for flat lap polishing with your pumice. Today I'm going to show you how to use just a regular synthetic felt pad and pumice to achieve a nice pre-polished finish on the glass that's really going to cut down on my cerium time for the polishing. This is just a synthetic felt material, non-perforated and solid, works a little bit better with the pumice than the perforated materials do. You can also get Pulper's MJ material. They make this in much larger pieces that will fit onto a flat lap. So you can use this basically like on its side for use with pumice on a flat lap, and they work fantastic for cleaning up flat surfaces with pumice to really cut down on that polish time or just leave a really nice finish on the glass for you. So as we discussed earlier and you saw earlier, pumice is a powdered material. I have some 2F pumice here, which is my double fine pumice. It is a powder, but you're not going to be able to use it as a powder. But you don't want it as thin as cerium either. You'll want to try and make a mud consistency out of the pumice. That's the way it's going to work best, so it will cling to the glass and it will cling to your media that's going to hold your pumice, be it your cork wheel, your brush wheel, whatever like that. You want it to be able to stay onto the glass a little bit. So I'm going to mix a little bit of water in here and make this in sort of mud consistency, and then we're going to move over to our flat lap grinder and show you how to use this. Now all you're really looking to do is mix a little bit of your pumice in with the water. It's going to sink. You're going to have a little bit of a mud consistency out of your pumice. That's fine. That's what we're looking for on our glass as we work. Pumice can also be used as a great pre-polish step, as mentioned before. I'm going to show you a little bit of that today on our flat lap grinder by showing you a piece that I've moved through a diamond resin pad for a pre-polish on one side, and then we're going to finish up after that with some pumice on the other side to show you the differences, so it can really help cut down on your polishing time. So you see here on this piece, this is a piece that I have cut, ground, and polished, and I've moved it through a 325 grit diamond resin pad on both sides. Now I'm going to use pumice on one side of this to try and give you an idea of the differences between that. So hopefully if you can see a little bit, you can see what the surfaces are like. They're pretty much identical now. You can kind of see the scratches in there from the smoothing pad. So let's try and use the pumice on this and see how it works. So I've got my synthetic felt pad here, and like with anything else, I'm going to go ahead and get it wet. Now with pumice, like the cerium, you just want to keep things a little bit moist. You don't want to wash all your cerium off as you're using it. Having it in this mud consistency will be helpful in that. You can see my pumice in here. And I'm going to apply this directly to my glass surface and then work it onto the pad here. And we're going to see how this works. Like any loose abrasive, moving around on the wheel is going to be helpful to keep the abrasive moving in different directions on your piece. You can see still, I've got some pumice still on there, but I'm gonna add a little bit more. Just to make sure I've got pumice on the glass so it is working. Keep moving in different directions here and go against the flow of the pad. Let's take a quick look and see what this looks like. So you can see, after only a few minutes, it may be difficult to see on camera, but on my side where I use the pumice, I almost don't see any scratches from my diamond resin pad any longer. Now if you look at the opposite side, you can see a ton of scratches still. It's still very opaque. This side is very shiny and almost, I don't want to say it's polished, but it's super clear and translucent. You can see the reflection of the light in it, where the light reflection on this side is very, very dull. You can't even discern the lights. On this side, they're reflecting quite nicely from the ceiling. And that's with just a few minutes on the pumice step. It makes a huge difference, and that's a 2F pumice. You can go a little bit rougher if you want to. You can even move through different stages of the pumice. But just a little bit of extra work with one more stage, and that's gonna cut my polish down considerably. So I'm gonna be using less cerium and far less time on the polish pad by just adding in a pumice step to further refine my pre-polish step.